Thinking of Hue, the former citadel of Vietnam, people think of its typical weather, rainy. Maybe that's the reason why Hue people always keep the fire burning in their kitchens. It warms their hearts and stomachs with tasty goodies. Hue local cuisines, though cheap and simply made, charm even the most demanding foodies with their savory taste and delicate presentation. As a result, inexpensive foods are here in Hue, the renowned food capital of Vietnam.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Fine Cuisine. Now in this episode, we are in the old royal citadel of Vietnam, and that is no other than Hue. This city is known for its royal cuisine, but also another part of the cuisine here that is very close to the local people is street food, a wide variety of street food. And the first location that we are going to visit is a congee vendor store on the street that is very well known among the local people. So follow me.
Morning in Hue offers people fresh breezes from the Hương River and the good smell from the street food vendors' baskets. The selection of food here varies from noodles and rice cakes to different types of soups. Yet, for some reason, a simple dish like red rice porridge is still a local treat.
Món mà cá rím của mẹ là mẹ có rất là nhiều loại, thứ nhất là cá nục này, cá bông dừa này, tôm, rồi thịt mỡ. Là mẹ kho là hằng khi mà mình ăn cái là cá là sẽ có một cái vị là ngọt ngọt, hằng đai đai, nói chung là rất là thích.
Món ăn phổ biến không giống nhất ở Huế. Rẻ tiền, ngon. Sáng nào cũng ăn hết. Tuần là ăn hết 4-5 ngày thôi.
Cháo, cá với bông cao khô này là đặc trưng của là người Huế. Thì tức là những ai mà họ muốn tham quan về Huế thì họ cũng muốn tìm hiểu những món đặc trưng về Huế, ví dụ như là cơm hến, rồi bánh nậm bánh bèo. Nhưng mà buổi sáng người Huế thường thường là người ta tập trung là những cái món là cháo, về cái này là chỉ có bán buổi sáng sớm.
The light purple-red Hue of the porridge comes from the rice. Grown in Quảng Điền district in Hue, this rice variety is renowned for its high value of nutrients and its soft texture. The little goby fish that accompanies the porridge is also caught locally. Both the rice and the fish are slow cooked and braised so that they can reach the desired texture. The cellar lady has been in this place for more than 40 years. Her dish never changes, neither do her many regular customers. Her presence and her savory porridge have made eating out in the street even more enjoyable for the locals.
Con thấy là có rất là nhiều người đến ăn mà họ đều khen ngon. Bà có cái bí quyết gì mà hay đấy ạ?
Bí quyết là gạo lứt mình để lứt. Gạo lứt mình dạ cho sạch sẽ, cho làm cho sạch sẽ, cho máy tẩy hết. Lá thơm là giữa, bỏ vô. Rồi bà quấy, bà đầy bàn lại.
Thế thì cái công đoạn mà làm cái món cháo này thì là bà bắt đầu phải làm từ mấy giờ ạ?
1 giờ sáng bà làm rồi.
1 giờ sáng ạ?
Rồi khi là làm nấu, được sôi, đổ gạo vô. Rồi xây lại là sửa soạn nấu đậu trắng này về nước non rồi đứa bà đủ thì giờ bà bỏ xe bà kéo ra bán thôi.
À thế ạ? Thì là mấy giờ là bà bắt đầu đi bán rồi bà?
1 giờ sáng là bán đen luôn.
Now, congee is a very typical breakfast for Vietnamese people, especially in Hue City. Even though it is very, you know, normal and everybody eats it every day, but it is still something that once you have had a taste, you would never ever forget.
In Hue, street food alliances are amazingly strong. Cooks and diners rely on each other. Provided that you have loyalty, you will never end up alone and hungry. However, as I am a foodie, I don't limit myself to one dish or one vendor. It's fun to have multiple regular spots on the go as long as they serve different food. Hin Islet emerges from the middle of the Hương River. It is connected to the land by a narrow bridge.
Now the next place we're heading to is Cồn Hến, which literally means mussel islet. Many street vendors live here and they commute every day to the city to sell food. So this is also one of the best places to find cheap and good food. Just follow me to find more.
The river bottom is covered with carpets of mud, home to the variety of mussels for which the area is famous. Local people have been living by catching the tiny mussels for generations. While part of the catch is sold in Hue's market, the rest is made into delicious foods. I am visiting a mussel processing household in Hin Islet.
A special thing about the mussels of this area is that they are really, really small. They're just so tiny. That's the big difference from mussels anywhere else. And that's also the reason why the rice made from this mussel here in Cồn Hué is the best that there is.
Miss Châu Thị Nở, the owner, inherited the trade from her mother more than 20 years ago. What she does every day is shucking the mussels. I want to give her a helping hand so that I can understand more about the trade.
Bây giờ mình sẽ phải khuấy lên đúng không ạ? Mình dùng cái này luôn hả cô? So this step, where I'm stirring these mussels, what it does is it helps the meat of the mussels detach from the shell. So you have to make sure you stir it really hard so that they can actually get the meat out, just like this. It's a lot of hot work. Vâng. Làm hến như này cô thì có còn giữ lại được ở đây nhiều không ạ? Mọi người vẫn các gia đình quanh đây vẫn làm ạ?
À, cũng là như ở cha mình làm ra để làm.
À vâng. Bây giờ là mình đang làm gì đây cô?
À, không làm như là mình đãi ra để nhân.
Đãi ra để lấy nhân ạ? Tức là mình cứ xoa đều như thế, xong rồi là cái nhân tự nó sẽ rơi ra hả cô?
Từ lên rồi lấy bên mình tới ra.
Hết ra.
Now he cleans the boy mussels while separating their shells. Mussel flesh is what we will need to cook Hin Island's specialty.
Cô ơi, thế thì cái hến ở đây của mình, nhà mình làm ấy, thì có các loại hến khác không? Hay là hến nào cũng bé bé này cô?
Có hến to, to nữa nó dùng để nấu cháo.
À, to thì là nấu cháo, còn chỉ có hến nhỏ này thì là...
Cơ, mới nắng cơm hến.
À.
Rice mixed with mussels is something beyond my imagination at first. Just yesterday's leftover rice, but when it's mixed with veggies, roasted peanuts, sesame, tiny cooked mussels, some spicy sauce, and voila, we have a dish. An awesome dish. As for me though, it comes to my mind that the mussel rice is a Vietnamese version of paella, a Spanish signature dish. Just like people in Spain love to cook the dish creatively, Hue people season their mussel rice to suit their taste buds. A guest to Hin Islet, I have a chance to taste the original cơm hến.
There are so many flavors that go into this one small bowl. It's crunchy, nutty, sweet, and salty, spicy at the same time. I wonder how they can make this food so good. Cô ơi, cô, con vừa ăn cái món cơm hến của cô ấy thì con thấy rất là ngon. Thì cô có thể chỉ cho con cách cô làm như thế nào được không ạ?
À, được, chị dẫn cho chế biến cơm hến.
Dạ vâng.
As the name suggests, mussel rice main ingredients are mussels and rice. But to have a great taste, you also need spices and herbs as well.
Here we have Vietnamese cilantro, taro, onions, and star fruit. And these are the ingredients that will add to the flavors to the dish. Bây giờ cô có thể chỉ cho con cách chế biến thì là như thế nào hả cô?
Chế biến nguyên liệu á, chế biến nguyên liệu rất quan trọng, cho nên mình phải cố gắng làm cho những nguyên liệu được thật mềm mại, thơm ngon.
According to Miss Hà Thị Hoa, vegetables and fruits used to make the mussel rice should be very fresh because we are going to eat them raw.
Cơm hến này ở Huế có từ bao giờ cô?
Rất nhiều đời rồi, nhưng ngày cơm hến là ngày truyền thống của đời. Ông cha ta để lại,
vâng.
Mình nổi gọt cha sao.
The most important step in making mussel rice is to prepare the mussels. So this is what we're going to do now. First, she is going to add cooking oil to the pan.
Trước khi mình xào quá là bỏ dầu.
Vâng. Vậy thì đầu tiên là mình sẽ xào gì trước ạ?
Bỏ dầu xong mình phi hành.
Phi hành đầu tiên ạ, vâng.
Phi hành đầu tiên dùng thơm.
The first thing is you have to stir fry the onions. Khoảng gần này hến thì là sẽ đủ cho bao nhiêu bát cơm đấy ạ?
10 tô.
10 suất cơm ạ.
Đục gia vị.
Gia vị. So you have to add some spices to it. Và như thế là mình sẽ thêm cơm vào và thêm các loại rau. Là như thế là sẽ thành một
tô
cơm hến đầy đủ. So I think this is not a very difficult step to do. The steps are really easy to follow. And now we have the final product. This smells very good. It looks great as well. There's not too many colors into this dish yet, but once you add the vegetables, you will start to see it's very mouth-watering and the scent is nice. When you add rice to it as well, it's going to taste very good. Now, unlike other Vietnamese dishes that are eaten with hot rice, this dish is actually eaten with cold rice. And according to Ms. Hoa, this is just part of the tradition, and the dish actually tastes better when you eat with cold rice. So I'm just going to leave this here to cool down for a second while I'm going to go over here to prepare my own dish and see if it tastes like what I had earlier. I'm going to try my best to remake what was what I tasted earlier. I remember there was vegetables in here, so that's the first thing, and we also made that earlier, so I'm sure that's part of the dish. Now, rice was definitely part of the dish, so I'm going to add that.
To me, rice mixed with mussels is a healthy dish. Not much rice, a lot of veggies, and the taste is gently rich. However, the dish could be a little bit strong due to the shrimp paste and the spices. Anyway, I love to recommend that you try it, particularly if you have a chance to visit the Hain Island.
And I'm pretty sure every single dish in Hue has the shrimp paste, so a little bit of that and then some vegetable on the top for decoration. I think that's it. I'm done. Cô bây giờ cái bát này cháu làm ra như này thì có đúng không ạ?
Chưa đúng, con thiếu.
À chưa đúng.
Con thiếu.
À còn thiếu khế nữa.
Khế chua.
Vâng.
À thêm giá ngò vào nữa là.
Và thêm rau ngò. À vậy còn các cái gia vị ạ thì lúc nãy con thực ra là các cái món chính thì con nhớ. Nhưng mà gia vị thì đúng là khó có thể nhớ được bởi vì là lúc mà ăn thì rất là nhiều thứ. Con rất là cảm ơn cô ạ. Hôm nay đã cho con cơ hội được đến để học về món cơm hến và được nhất là thưởng thức cái món cơm hến rất là ngon của cồn hến mình ạ. À, nước ở đây có ngập lên không ạ? Nước đây có ngập lên không? Ba vụ cơ ạ? Ba vụ là vào khoảng tháng mấy ạ? Now after the mussel rice, the next dish we're going to taste is corn sweet soup. I was very lucky that I met Miss Phuc here, who has taken me to this cornfield where we can actually harvest the corn, and then from that corn we'll make the dish. But first let's see how we actually harvest it.
People in Hue say the best corn comes from a field in Hin Islet. Here, the alluvial soil from the Huang River enriches local fields year after year. Local women often celebrate their bounty corn seasons by putting corn into the sweet soup, and that has now become a dessert that is very famous locally.
Thế cái đặc điểm của cái bắp này là thế nào mà tại sao nấu ra chè thì lại vừa dẻo vừa ngon được?
Vì cái đất ở Côn Hiển, cái đất phù sa nó lục lồi, nó bu vào á.
À.
Cho nên là nấu lúc nào bắp cũng thơm ngon này.
À thế ạ. Dì chỉ cho con xem là những cái bắp nào hái được.
Con mà bẻ bắp mà để nấu chè á,
vâng.
Là phải bỏ bẻ bắp vừa, không già mà
dạ.
Không non.
Dạ vâng. Như là cái bắp này là được đúng không ạ?
Những cái bắp này là được.
Còn này nữa cô.
Cô đi tiếp đi, cô đi tiếp đi.
Còn này có lấy không ạ? I'm starting to understand now how to pick the right corn. It's actually quite simple if you follow all the steps that you are instructed to do. But the one disadvantage, I guess, about doing this is, first of all, it's very sunny out here. If you're out here for too long, you probably get shocked from the heat waves. And these leaves right here, they actually make you itch really, really bad. So you want to just get this done quick and then get out of here. That's what I'm going to try to do now.
We went back to Miss Phuc's house to start cooking corn sweet soup. I think I can easily fall in love with the preparation process of making this dessert. It's quick and it's simple. Local people here use a special type of kernel cutter knife to remove the kernels from corn cobs.
You know, I'm starting to get the hang of it now. At the beginning, it was really difficult because I didn't really know what to do. But I learned one secret. Now, that may be just a secret to me because probably a lot of people already know how to do this. But what I learned is that if you put one finger on the lower blade and you push it down when you're cutting, then the pressure that is applied onto that blade will make it go deeper and easier into the corn. Now another ingredient to the sweet corn soup is pandanus leaves. What we have to do with this first though, before adding it to the soup, is we're going to clean it. Now with this ingredient added, the dish is going to have a nice scent and a very good taste as well.
The pandan leaf adds a grassy floral note that's very Vietnamese for a dessert. After we boil the leaf, we take it out and put the corn into the boiling water. It took us less than 10 minutes to cook sweet corn soup. When the corn soup becomes coarse, add the sugar to your taste.
Now since the corn is naturally quite sweet by itself, we don't have to add too much sugar or any kind of sweetener. This is probably already good enough. I think it's just about at the right. Yes, it's just about right now, so we're going to have a taste of it. Cô bây giờ chắc là chín rồi, đủ rồi đúng không ạ?
Sôi, đổ đường vào mà nó sôi lại là được thôi.
Vâng.
Sweet corn soup is best with ice cubes. However, people in Hin Islet often serve the dessert in bowls and have it just like this. It is so simple, yet really delightful to me. My trip to explore cheap Hui food has led me to the final location, the local night market. Here, young people and tourists can enjoy the beautiful scenery of the Changdian Bridge and the Hung River at night. My radar was on Phat, a sweet vendor. Phat stall is often one of the busiest places in the night market.
Very good. We waited, and it's funny to see here to see him work. So I'm very happy. My first day in Hue, it's very nice.
Yeah, em ăn là em thích nhất là dưa với là cái cà tớ của hắn á. Ăn là ngọt 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 với vui miệng.
Many Vietnamese love this candy, especially in our childhood.
Anh Pháp ơi, hôm nay anh bán đã được nhiều chưa?
Dạ, cũng được nhiều ạ.
Được bao nhiêu rồi anh?
Dạ, thì cũng không biết, bây giờ mới nhận được...
Phải được mấy chục cái chứ anh nhỉ?
Được 150 cái ạ.
Ủa, 150 cái rồi ạ? Ui dồi ôi, một buổi tối là anh bán được khoảng bao nhiêu cái tổng cộng?
Dạ, cỡ 150, 170
cái. Khoảng 150, 170 cái hả anh? À, anh ơi, thế thì bây giờ anh sẽ làm thử cái công đoạn là kéo cái kẹo ra xem nó như thế nào nha anh nhé. Okay, so I'm going to give this a try. I'm not entirely sure how it's done, but we just have to go along with the flow here. Ủa, cái này. Anh chỉ cho em một chút, đây là em sẽ kéo ra đúng không ạ?
Cái tay anh đây, xong rồi kéo từ từ thôi, kéo từ từ thôi, từ từ thôi thôi.
The way we prepare thread candy is exactly the same way people do with fresh noodles at a noodle shop. We stretch the candy with sugar powder into thin, long strands that are twisted together. After that, we put on a kind of rice paper topped with coconut shreds and roasted sesame. And it's done.
All right, first cake. See if anyone wants to buy it. Ai mua mua bánh không ạ? Ai mua bánh không ạ? Ai mua kẹo chỉ không ạ? A lot of people are watching, but nobody wants to buy any. Ăn thử cái nhá. Nhá. But since nobody wants to buy any that I make, so I'm just going to eat this myself.
Sweet vendors are no longer visible in many places in Vietnam. This old-fashioned candy will sooner or later be replaced by many sweets that we get from convenience stores around the country. But in this image, I taste and smell not only the sweet, I also feel the connection with the past, with my childhood.
I think this is very good. It actually is. I don't know why nobody wants to buy mine. I mean, it's really good. Now, kẹo chỉ, or thread candle, also wraps up this journey of ours today. So remember, Hue does not only have royal cuisine, there's also another side to the cuisine culture of this city, and that is the cheap and tasty cuisine of the local street vendors. Remember, all these dishes can be bought for only 5,000 Vietnamese dong each, which is only a quarter of a US dollars. So thank you very much for being here with us today on this episode of Phan Cuisine, and goodbye for now from us.